geschreven is daar. Seth Bosman nam de opleiding van deze talentvolle ruim op zich tot een lichte tour. En daarna was het zijn partner Robin van Lierop die de teugels overnam en leidde hem op tot de Grand Prix. Inmiddels starten ze ook samen succesvol in de Grand Prix. En daarom zijn we dan ook heel blij dat RSG Dressage heeft gezorgd dat Patrick Kittel hier rond kan rijden met deze mooie QBU No MS2. Patrick, als het goed is, heb jij geluid. Patrick, when it's okay, you have your own.
Perfect. I love that. Only when I ride and when I come into the arena with a new horse, I get very like focused. It's a bit like when you go into the ring. Normally I'm a really, really nervous rider like before. And then when I come into the test and I see Marietta or some of her colleagues, they don the bell. And then I get totally into my own world and then I forget everybody else. And I forget who's sitting anywhere. And I just do my thing with the horse, and especially when I'm on a new horse like this, I do the same. I sort of like just, hoppala, hi, you're all here. And you sort of like, you forget that, because for me, I just in that moment go into the horse so much and try to figure him out, especially now when I ride on a new horse. This is a very like new partnership with me, and I've never, you know, I sat on him once, Robin showed him to me one time, and this is the second time I ride him. And you know, it's always when you do new horses, and when you start with new horses, it's a lot to learn, it's a lot of communication. It's helping people walking, so good way. There you go. And it's only like, you know, new communication for you and the horse. And I always say, you know, when you start with a new horse, you do a lot of mistakes. But I also think it's okay, and it's also for me, you will see I will do thousands of mistakes today in this ride, but I don't care. I always think like through mistakes I learned to get better. When I was younger and I started riding, a lot of people told me again that I could never make it because I was sitting like this when I started and I was like really sitting like this. And you know, they all said that if you don't have the talent to sit well, you don't have the, what is that? They all really like, yeah, let's see if we can get off.
Een opblaaspaard.
So, when I started, it was I was nothing special when I started riding. But if it's one thing I have learned through my years in the saddle, is that maybe I will never sit as good a child at JNL. But I compensate with doing other things. And I think, you know, work with your weaknesses, accept them, get better at them, but also be happy for your strengths. You know, we all have something unique that we can bring to the horse. We all have something that no one else has when we ride. And I think that's what we need to develop. And I think someone asked me today why I'm successful and why I've educated so many horses. That's because I try. When I start, I don't say, no, this is not going to work. I say, okay. Like, for example, when I got Scandi, you know, he had a couple of other riders before me. He wasn't the easiest horse. But, you know, I said, I love this horse. We try. We did, and you know, when I was in Rotterdam and took a medal, I think that was like the highlight of my equestrian career, because it was sort of like me and this horse, but no one thought, you know, I don't think anyone thought of me and the horse, and suddenly we were there and we took a medal. And that's for me really cool. I was just a couple of days in Göteborg and I met this very famous man. I'm not going to say his name, but he has a very successful businessman, and when I was little, I used to like always play with the toys, and you know, I met him and I said, it's so incredible to meet this guy, and he looked at me and he said, a kid's dream is a man's reality. And I think that's really what I live for. That when you start, dream big, and you will somehow always get to where you want. So when I started with this horse, well, I'm a little bit different from others. I don't care how he trots, I just want him to trot around here with me. And I just want him to look at everything here and get a positive feeling from the stadium, get a positive feeling for me, because we don't know each other. And for me to get to know him, I need to be able to trust him and he needs to be able to trust me. So I need to be able to, like, just the basic here, let's go on my diagonal, see that I can. I'm just having the time of it because I was a little bit scared here. Not going too fast. Make sure I can give a little bit on the inside. And if it's a little bit looking, I tried to dig him a little bit inside, just a tiny bit of shouldering, so that he comes in his comfort zone. Straight. See, it's a nice bit in front. I have good contact. It's not empty in the hand, but it's also not strong in the hand here. I feel that I can change the neck a little bit how I want. I can go straight on the diagonal. I can look where I'm riding. This you can all do when you work the horse just when you start. A little bit better to the inside here, so that if he gets scared, he looks into the safety zone, which is here, which I can cross. Do a little bit of tiny shoulder in again, just so that he feels straight. I turn a little bit. Same thing here when you start. Be creative in the way you're riding. Don't always go around the track. You know? Just maybe turn a little bit here. You know, and go this way. Oh no, change my mind. My God, this is also really good alcoholic test on a Saturday morning. Make sure that you can ride around on the straight and on the crooked line. So, good boy. And just make sure that you use the space of the indoor and not just stay on one track. Show that the horse is happy, straight, on the leg. Same the canter. For me, he doesn't have the canter so much. He has to be straight on the hand. He has to go forward when I come with the leg. And when I come back with the hand, I want him to come back a little bit. And then I want to be able to go forward. But I also want to come back. I must want to turn, keep the outside shoulder straight. I feel like I can almost bend a tiny bit to the outside in between, but also a tiny bit to the inside. I don't want to overbend the neck, because for me, when I overbend the neck, I always lose the shoulders. I want to make sure I can put the inside leg on a little bit. I can also lose the voice. Oh, oh. I want to be able to go to trot. Straight on the line, let him go out to the outside. Sit. Enter, it's a little slow in the leg, but he's also looked a little bit there. Go, go. Do it again. Oh, good. Position was good. And then do the canter again. That was good. Stand a bit to the inside if it looks a bit. Because horses are looking. But the more we focus on the looking, instead of focusing on getting him to listen, the more he will go against you. If you focus on getting him to listen instead of worrying about the looking, you will get him a lot quicker where you want him to be. And instead of now forcing him to go through that corner all the time, because he got a bit afraid of the people who do so. Good boy. I just go a little bit more on the inside here, and let him get the confidence in that corner instead. Change the rein. Super. And I control. The voice. So. Stretch the neck, go forward, good. It's not a forward. People moving. Stretch the neck a little bit. Think I know. Go, go, go. Go, go, good. Think I know. So that I always, no matter what, can always get him to walk and walk in a good way. This is always what I start with. No matter what horse I'm on, no matter where I am, I always want the horse, first of all, to relax, trust me, and feel the environment in a good way. And once I have this, then I start working. And this can sometimes take a bit longer, especially if I have a really hot horse, but it's not even well done, and I still work on it, to get it really, really just calm and soft, because she has so much energy, which is so positive, but I need to control the energy so that she's not just hot in energy, she has to be controllable in a positive way. Then I start taking him a little bit up. And the same thing here, I don't want to go too fast. Then a little bit to the inside, make sure I have the quarter straight. If it looks a little bit, I get the shoulder. Also for me, it's really good in the walk because I can think like Isabella always said to me, "Pook a bit." That is like sort of like getting horses back. I think if you can translate it. For me, it's always important that I work on myself. And every day when I ride, I always try to think of one thing that I work with. And normally it's keep your shoulders back. then think, okay, today I need to work with this, today I need to work with that, so then I start chopping them up.
Well,
for example, in the changes, we all have weaknesses. And I'm nervous. When I come, you know, when I go into Amsterdam, or the Bosch, or wherever I go, and you are there and you're watching me, I don't want to make mistakes. I want you to be happy with me. And then I start, you know, going back to old habits because I want to make it good. And I think, you know, if you can accept your weaknesses and work on them again,